Dear students, today let us learn about rate analysis. It belongs to module 3, part B. As we all know, to complete any project, any construction activity, there are different stages of work which needs to be completed. And each and every stage of work require different types of materials, equipment, tools, labors, etc. And respectively, its cost also varies to complete each and every stages of work. Example, for earthwork excavation, it may require different span of time. For to complete PCC work or any concrete works or any size stone masonry or brick masonry, any kind of work, the cost required to complete each item of work is different depending on the type of labors required and quantity of materials required. So to sum up with, to complete any kind of work, for any item of work, for unit item of work, that means for 1 cubic meter of work or for any 1 square meter of plastering work or painting work, there has to be some set of rate to be fixed. How to fix the rate? Depending on the quantity of materials and quantity of labors and time required to complete the work. So this rate analysis gives the correct and reasonable rate per unit item of work following its specification. This is the definition of rate analysis. I'll repeat it. Rate analysis is the basis of arriving at the correct and reasonable rate per unit item of work following its specification. We all know that what is the specification. To do any particular item of work, there are set of rules to be followed. So to following such specifications, such guidelines, to complete any particular work, unit item of work is for 1 cubic meter of brick masonry work or 1 square meter of plastering work or 1 square meter of painting work, anything. To do that, what is the rate required? That calculation process is rate analysis. So it includes cost of materials, that is the calculation of cost of materials, cost of labors, cost of equipment, tools and plants required for that, and cost of water charges and cost of overhead and profit. This sum, all these sum is the rate analysis. The procedure of finding out these is the rate analysis. And to find the cost of materials, you should know what are the different types of materials required for that particular item of work. Say PCC bed means how much quantity of cement, sand and coarse aggregate required for that, along with the rates of individual material should be known, and that should be standard. Cost of labor, number of labors and their wages per day should be known. But this cost of tools and plants, we should put lump sum. Cost of water charges is 1 to 2% of cost of materials and labors, whatever we get. After calculating this, we should sum up. Out of that, 1 to 2% will be the water charge, and the profit will be 10% of total cost of all these things will be the profit. So if we add all those things, whatever we get, that is the total cost. Rate per unit item of work is total cost divided by the total quantity. As I said, this rate analysis should give the rate of 1 cubic meter or 1 square meter, or for one number it should be. To do the rate analysis, we will be considering either 10 cubic meter or 100 square meter of any work, and then we will be dividing the total cost divided by the quantity which you have taken for the calculation purpose. That will give the rate per unit item of work. This is about the rate analysis. As I said, we will be considering for mass works 10 cubic meter, that is for cement, concrete work, stone or brick masonry work, we will be considering 10 cubic meter, calculating it and then dividing the total cost by 10. For surface works like pointing, plastering, flooring area, we will be considering the 100 square meter and then after the calculation, we will be dividing the total cost by 100. Running meter, we will be considering the 100 running meters for pipeline works, etc. And for unit quantities like fixing of plumbing items such as wash basins and all, we will be doing directly for one number. This I'll explain this later. Now, we have different types of labors in our rate analysis. To do any construction activity, all the works cannot be done by a single person with single skill set. Each labors will be having different skill set and they are named as follows. Head mason, he will be heading the construction activity, just like a leader who gives the instructions for the construction activity. And mason, he will be laying off or he will be dealing with units of the blocks. That means it may be of bricks, stones, blocks, tiles, etc. Mason, he is an unskilled labor. He will do the work, whatever the works assigned to him. Bisti, he is the person who supplies water for the construction activity. Carpenter, as we know, he is a wood worker. Barbender, or he is also called as blacksmith, who works on steel reinforcement like that. Polisher, who do the polishing for mosaic tiles, etc. He is a person who is well versed in polishing. Next, we have fixed number of labors for different set of works. We should remember this. For 100 cubic meter of following items of work, we have different labors numbers required. For example, for earthwork excavation in ordinary soil, we need only master. We don't want head mason, mason, carpenter, barbender, all these things, all these persons we don't want, only master. For about 3.25, sorry, this is 10 cubic meter. For 10 cubic meter of these works, or for 10 cubic meter of earthwork excavation in ordinary soil, we need 3.25 masdar. You may feel that why this 0.25? If we multiply this by 4, we may get whole number. But since we are doing 10 cubic meter of work, if we divide it, we will get 3.25. Since we are considering for 10 cubic meter, we should take this decimal number itself. Don't round it off. Next, for earth filling, we need 2.5 masdar. For ready mix concrete work, we need 2 number of mason and 3 number of masdar and 3 bisti. Similarly, for RCC work, we need a head mason of half number, masdar 3, mason 3, masdar 20, and bisti 2.5, carpenter 3, and barbender 5. Wherever you see the blank spaces, you consider that that particular labor is not required. We have to consider only wherever we have the numbers corresponding to these labors, only that we have to remember. Similarly, for surface works like flooring, tile flooring, red oxide or laying of tiles, plastering, along for all these things, we need these types of labors. This is for 100 square meter of work. And for painting and all, we need only painter and helpers. We have these numbers. These you have to remember. Labors for door and windows, we need carpenter and carpenter assistants of these numbers. And this will be different. These two are for 100 square meter, and for door and window, for this size woodwork, this set of or these number of labors are required. You have to remember this. And in different textbooks, you have different numbers or different labors. This is prepared by just approximating with all the textbooks or all the materials which I had. And these numbers are easy to remember. If you refer some of the textbook, you may feel that this may not be 15, this may be 18 or 13, but I have rounded off to 15 like that. It may be more or less than this. You may, in your exams also, even if you vary one or two, it's fine. It's not standard. Why? Because if you consider a Bisti, different person will be having different capacity and different output. Output of the labors keeps changing. It depends on the place where you are working, weather condition and physical capacity of the labor and his skill to do the work, many things. The labor output depends on many factors. So these numbers are not constant. These are approximated by referring different materials. So, and also it is easy to remember. I have just rounded off like this, 10, 15, 20, like that. It may not be same in different materials which you refer. Okay. Now, coming to the rates. For each and every materials, we will be having different rates, and also the labor wages also varies. These rates are as per schedule of rates 2018-19 Bangalore Circle. I have referred this, I'll just show the photo, by referring this book of the year 2018-19. After 2019, they have not given any of the reference books to refer. So I have referred this and I have taken only the materials and labor's rate which is required to for your topics under your syllabus. This books contains many things and many items of work, not only for the construction of building, it may be of roads, bridges, water works, anything. This books will be supplied by the public works department, that is in the PWD office. You will be getting this book. I have already explained about this book in the class. So in this book, they have not given any amount for the head mason. So I have approximately written as 500. For the mason, they have given 466.22 rupees. But I have approximated to the next round figure, that is 470. Similarly, for each and every labors, they have given this decimal numbers. You can round it off. And this amount also, these are all not constant. If practically, it may not be there. But this is as per this book. It depends on the place also. In the Bangalore, at different places, it may be different. But this rates is purely based on this book. If you refer different textbooks or different materials, these rates may not be there. It may vary, but these are approximately I have written. In your calculations also, while writing these rates, if you use these rates, you have to write this line compulsorily before you start the rate analysis. These rates are taken as per the schedule of rates 2018-19 Bangalore Circle. This should be written, must and should. And material rates, only you need these materials. So I have taken only this. Regular cement, it is two. They have in the book, they have written 245.3. I have approximated to 250 rupees per bag. And in the fine aggregate, you have natural sand and M sand. For both, they have given these number. I have approximated to these numbers. Similarly, for all the materials which are listed here, these are the rates which is given in SR book, and these are the numbers which I have approximated, which is easy to remember for you people. So you have to remember these numbers. Okay. Before we start any rate analysis, you should be able to remember all this. So now I'll start with the problem. First, I felt this would be better to explain. Now I'm working out for the rate analysis of plain cement concrete of proportion 1:4:8 for foundation. Before I start this, as I said, for since it is a concrete work, we have to assume the 10 cubic meter. We will be calculating it for 10 cubic meter, and at the end, the rates will be divided by 10 to get the total rate per cubic meter of concrete work. So your question in your exam will be like this. Work out from the first principles the rate analysis for bed concrete 1:4:8 for foundation. So before we start, we will be you should know that this 10 cubic meter is the wet volume. We are considering the we need 10 cubic meter of ready volume of the concrete which should be ready for the work. So to get the net 10 cubic meter of concrete, there will be a wastage of 15% of it. These are through the trial and error basis, these numbers are taken, these percentages are taken. So 15% of 10 cubic meter will be 1.5 cubic meter. So now the volume will become 10 plus 1.5, so it will be 11.5. This is the wet volume. To get this 11.5 cubic meter of wet volume, there for the dry volume, we should add additional 1/3. That is, in this 11.5, 1/3 will be the excess should be there to get the dry volume, because all the materials which we will be working out will be in the dry form. That we have to consider the volume in the dry form. So to get the 10 cubic meter of the wet volume, there should be an addition of 1/3 extra. This is not 1/3 of 10 cubic meter. Now we have arrived at 11.5. Out of this 11.5, it's 1/3. So it will be 3.83. So add both, you will get 15.33 cubic meter. You can round it off to 15.34 cubic meter. So to get the 10 cubic meter of wet volume of the mix, we need to work out the quantities for 15.34 cubic meter of dry mix. So our quantities, we will be working for 15.34, even we need 10 cubic meter. In this 15.34, we need to find out what is the amount of cement, sand, coarse aggregate, depends on the ratios, everything varies. So let us start the problem. This is the basis for any kind of rate analysis. So let us start our work. So your exam paper should contain whatever I'm explaining now. If they ask this question, your exam paper should contain all these things for the rate analysis from now. So let us consider the 10 cubic meter. We know that to get the materials for 10 cubic meter, we need to work out for 15.34 cubic meter, which includes the wastage and dry volume. This line you should write. So now we will be working out the material for 15.34 cubic meter. Out of 15.34 cubic meter, as they have given 1:4:8 ratio, one part will be of cement. In this concrete, one part will be of cement, four part will be of sand, and eight parts will be of coarse aggregate. So how to get it? This 15.34 should be divided by the sum of whatever the ratios they have given. That is 1 plus 4 plus 8. This you might have learned in concrete lab, but I'll be repeating this. So if it is of 1:3:6 ratio, you should add 1 plus 3 plus 6 like that. So this 15.34 should be divided by 1 plus 4 plus 8. You will be getting 1.18 cubic meter. So that means in this whole 15.34 cubic meter, 1.18 cubic meter, that is one part. If you divide 15.34 into 8 plus 9, 13 parts, the one part volume will be 1.18 cubic meter antra. So in this, since one part is of sand, 1 into 1.18 is 1.18 cubic meter of cement, and sand will be four parts, so 4 into 1.18, coarse aggregate will be eight parts, so 8 into 1.18. These are the different materials in cubic meters. But we have the rate of the cement in terms of bags, not in terms of cubic meter. So we have to convert this 1.18 into bags. How to convert? We should know this. One bag of cement contains 50 kgs of cement, and if you convert it into volume, it will come to 0.0347 cubic meter. So 1.18 cubic meter of cement will be equal to 1.18 divided by 0.0347. That contains 34 bags of cement. That means 1.18 cubic meter means 34 bags of cement. So for this proportion, we need to add 34 bags of cement. You have to remember this new table for the rate analysis, which includes serial number, description of the work or items of work, quantities, unit, rate per unit, and amount. So now, first let us work out for materials. What are the materials we require here? Cement, sand, coarse aggregate, and we have chosen as 40 mm downsize. For 148 foundation, we need to have 40 mm downsize. We have to take, since it is also for foundation, we can go for 40 mm downsize of coarse aggregate. So now cement is 34 bags, sand is 4.72, which we have calculated here, and coarse aggregate will be 9.44 from here, and units are, cement will be in bags and these two are in cubic meter. Coming to the rate, we have to take from this table. I'll be sending this file so you can refer this. For the cement, for per bag, we have 250 rupees. So write 250 here. Sand, let us take as a natural sand, that is 1700 per cubic meter. You can write here natural sand also. And coarse aggregate 40 mm downsize, in this we have 1100 rupees. So we are going to write here 1100. And in this amount column, you should multiply this quantity and with the rate to get this. Okay. Now, second part of this table is labors. What kind of labors required and how many number of labors required are important. So since it is a concrete work, we can refer this table, which you have to remember. Cement concrete work we have here. We need head mason, mason, mazdor, and distri. Head mason 0.25, mason 2, mazdor 10, and distri 2. Just copy it, whatever you had that numbers and their corresponding rates. Similarly, from this table, head mason 500 rupees, mason 470, mazdor 450, distri 450. So write whatever the rates are there. And similarly, for the amount, quantity, and rate, you have to add it, multiply it, and get the amount. Now, you have to put the third part, that is contingencies, tools, and plants, which is required to complete this PCC work. Just put the lump sum amount as 300. You can put 400 or 500 also. This also varies for different set of work, different items of work. This lump sum work varies. This may not be constant. Since it is lump sum, you can put some amount. Total. First, you had whatever you have in this column, amount column, add it up. You will get this amount. In this total, 1.5% is water charge. That is, to get this, 1.5% of 33,673 rupees, whatever you have, out of that, 1.5% is this. And 10% is 10% of 33,000, whatever the amount is there, out of that, 10% is contractor's profit. Now sum all this, you will get 37,545.39 rupees. Now, rate per cubic meter, whatever the amount you have, you should divide it by whatever the quantity which you have taken for the calculation, that is 10 cubic meter. If you divide it, you will get 3,754.5 rupees. So, 3,754 rupees is required to construct 1 cubic meter of 148 foundation of concrete for foundation work. This is the rate analysis. Whatever the work you have, first you should know what are the materials required and what are the types of labors required and how many labors required, and contingencies, water charge and contractor's profit. This is about the rate analysis of foundation work. Next, I'll come with the next items of work. Thank you.